welcome to the Game Changers video. This video details our problem solving strategy for the case competition. Step one was to define what child welfare is. Child welfare was defined for children between the ages of 0 to 23 and was broken up into the following three sections: health, education, and safety. Looking at health, we're looking at mortality rates, vaccination availability, and access to hospitals. In terms of education, it's two simple things: access to education as well as the quality of education received. Next up is safety, an important aspect where children feel protected and can develop naturally. Our next step was to relate child welfare to South Africa, so we gathered some stats. Under healthcare, it was extremely worrying as we found that for kids between the ages of 0 to 4, there were 70,000 deaths last year. In terms of education, we have good access. 97% of children have access to education, but the quality is poor, as only 1 in 3 after 6 years of school have literacy. And in safety, a very worrying fact occurs. As 84% of violent acts against children, the perpetrator is known by the victim.
Next, Keena has given me the opportunity to explain to you why we've chosen the ages between 0 and 5. Conventional wisdom up to now has been thought that most of the learning is done after the ages of 6. While this thought has been put on its head, now it's known that toddlers have up to twice as much brain activity than college students. We went and looked at South Africa's current situation, and we saw that out of the current learners in South Africa, only 3.4 are preschoolers. From these 3.4%, 36.9 is independent. This shows a great need for development and development in that area.
Given our definition of child welfare, we need to refine our scope to the area that needs our help the most, to the area that's accessible, affordable, and most importantly, where our impact can be sustained into the future by the community. Let's backtrack for a second. Our three focus areas are defined in this diagram here, and you can clearly see where we want to target, where education and safety overlap. We've also highlighted the importance of the 0 to 6-year-old age group. So let's take these two concepts and apply it to South Africa as a whole. Out of the total children under the age of 6 years, only 20% have access to any sort of education facility prior to grade 1. In numbers, that's only 1.2 million, leaving a total of 5 million spending their days playing on the street under untrained supervision, if any, even at all. These kids need a place to go, not only for their safety, but also for the security of their future. They need to be provided with a centre where a solid foundation can be built, where they can interact with peers and learn the basics in a supervised and healthy environment. Now that we have a target focus area and a target focus age group, let's narrow our market down even further, starting with province. We've identified KZN as the pre-primary school presence is particularly low compared to the other 9 South African provinces. Of total students who are in grade 1 in KZN, only 40% make it through the trip. The education stats are dire in this province, highlighted by even more shocking stats. So out of the literacy rates in KZN for children under the age or under the grade of 6, this stands at only 39%, which you can compare to the national average of 50%. Numeracy stands at 31% versus the national average of 40%. This could well be attributable to a lack of foundation phase institutions in the province. Next, we move on to identifying districts that meet the criteria for accessibility, affordability, and potential to make a solid, sustainable impact. This will be discussed further.
KwaZulu-Natal is divided into 4 educational regions. The two that we would like to focus on is Ukulamba and Zululand. The reason being is that they are primarily rural and have little metropolitan structures. They are heavily reliant on villages and communities as their centre of development. As following on from what Paula said, the pass rate in matric in 2007 was 49.29%. This might be at a matric level, but is very representative of the education level in these communities. We identified 2 primary schools in particular, the first being in Ukulamba, that will be the Winterton Primary School, and the second being Huvoland in Primary School in Zululand. The reason we have chosen these two schools to have our ECD centre attached to them is that they both are in the middle in the city of centre and are 2 kilometres from the high schools. They form an integral part of the community and therefore enhance our acceptability with parents and those within the community. Therefore, they will also act as a feeder to schools and provide a better education for our
Based on the above needs,
Our recommendation to the client would be to partner with Tree NGO for the project, as well as seek additional resources and funding from the government. This will be validated by two reasons. Firstly, Tree NGO are a company with 30 years experience in early childhood development centers. They are based in Durban and provide skills training programs for teachers, as well as community service programs for creating awareness about the program. Thus, they tie into our aims of our projects. They are located within our target area, and they provide the resource of advice and additional experience in construction of these centers. Secondly, the Department of Social Development provides funding specifically for the creation of these childhood development centers, and therefore our costs can be cut off by this.
As a great man once said, there can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way it treats its children. Child welfare is in our hands, and we're here to change the game. So do you want to go?